Hello friends, welcome back to my channel. Myself Yojana Gumawat. I am lecturer in chemical engineering of KKWA Polytechnic Nashik. Today I am going to tell you about the preparation of wood pulp by sulfate process, and this process is also known as the Kraft process, and this wood pulp is used for the manufacturing of paper. Pulp is commercial fibrous material obtained from the bamboo, wood, bagasse. Bagasse is a waste material which is obtained from the sugarcane, etc. And this is obtained by the mechanical and the chemical means. Pulping means the disintegration of the bulky fibrous material to the small fibers, and these small fibers will help us to form a paper. And there are mainly the three modes of production of pulp, that is mechanical method, chemical method, and the semi-chemical method. Now we will discuss about this sulfate process. It is most popular process for the pulp manufacturing, and this is an alkaline process. And in this process, we use the sodium sulfide, that is Na2SO4, to the cooking beaker. So its common name is a sulfate process. The presence of sodium sulfide makes the bleaching of the pulp easier, and the paper produced has a better strength. That's why we use sodium sulfide for this pulp manufacturing process. The raw materials required for this process are bamboo, bagasse, wood, recycled paper, agri residue. It depends upon the what type of pulp you want to form and what type of paper you want to form. Then we add some alkali for this process, that is sodium hydroxide, sodium sulfate, and sodium carbonate. Also, we add a chlorine and hydrogen peroxide for the bleaching of that pulp. Now, the chemical reaction involved in this process are digestion. Inside the digestion, hydrolysis and the solubilization of the lignin takes place. Here, this organic compound, means the raw material which we use for the pulp manufacturing, is reacted with the sodium hydroxide inside the digestion, and it gives the sodium salt of fatty acid and the alcohol. Again, the organic compound also reacts with the sodium sulfate, and it gives the mercaptan. The second reaction for this process are recovery, chemical recovery from the black liquor. Inside that, from the smelting process, we recover sodium carbonate and sodium sulfate. Now see the reaction. This is NaR, that is a lignin. When reacted with the air, it gives the Na2CO3. Then carbon dioxide. Then sodium sulfate reacted with the two molecules of carbon, and it gives the sodium sulfate and the two molecules of carbon dioxide. And this we obtained from the alkyl group. Okay, this is also known as Na2S, is also known as a white liquor. And the next reaction for the recovery from the black liquor is the causticizing. In causticizing, the green liquor, that is Na2CO3, aqueous Na2CO3, reacts with the solid calcium hydroxide, and it gives the sodium hydroxide as an aqueous white liquor and the COCO3 as a solid compound. And this COCO3 then again gives the calcium oxide and the calcium carbon monoxide. And this calcium oxide react, the calcium oxide obtained from this reaction react with the water molecule, it gives the calcium hydroxide. Means in this reaction, means in the chemical recovery from the black reaction, black liquor, in the smelting and the causticizing reaction, we get back the sodium carbonate, sodium sulfate, and sodium hydroxide as a white liquor, and which can be again used as a raw material for this digestion process. Now we will see the process for flow diagram of the Kraft process. Inside that, we add a chips, that is the solid chips from which we want to form a pulp. The solid chips are added in the chipper bins. Chipper bin, here cut logs are conveyed to the chipper, where the rotary tricks with the heavy knives reduce the wood size to the 2 to 5 centimeter flat chips. Inside this, a size reduction is done to maximize the penetration of the process chemical. Then this chopped flat chips then sent to the digester. This continuous digester have a 25 to 30 meter size. Chips are preheated with the volatilizing turpentine and the non-condensable gases inside this heater. For controlling the digestion temperature inside the digester, the cooking leaker as a side stream and the circulated through the heat exchanger. Means here, from here, we remove the cooking leaker, we cooled it, and again we send it to the digester for cooling the temperature of this digester. Cooking time inside the digester is about 1.5 hours at 170 degree Celsius. To avoid the mechanical weakening of the fibers, digested chips are cooled with this recycled black liquor. The temperature is maintained inside this is at 140 to 180 degree Celsius and pressure is at about the 10 atmosphere. Here we can see the white liquor from the recovery plant is again sent to this digester to maintain the temperature inside this digester tank. And the bottom temperature of this tank is maintained at the 65 degrees Celsius and it is maintained by the recovery of this black liquor. Means when we add this black liquor inside this tank, the temperature from the of the bottom side of the tank becomes lower and it becomes a 65 degree Celsius. And from this digester, it is sent to the blow down wall. This wall reduces the pressure of the stream from 80 atmosphere to the 1 atmosphere before entering to this blow tank. Inside this blow tank, when hot pulp slurry is passed through this blow tank, heat is recovered in the form of steam. Means steam is removed from this blow tank. The chips are preheated with this recovered steam. Means the steam which is coming out from the blow tank is sent back to this tank to heat the chips which are coming out from this chipper bin. This blow tank has high concentration of pulp and the low concentration of water. Means we have removed the water quantity in the form of steam from this blow tank and the concentrated pulp is then sent to the screens. Inside the screen, the pulp is screened so as to remove the wood knots and undigested residues. And that wood knots and the undigested residues are removed from this screen and it is used as a waste material. From this screen, it is sent to the series of, that pulp is sent to the series of filters. Inside this filter, the pulp is filtered to separate a black liquor for chemical recovery plant. Means from here, the black liquor is separated from the pulp and we have already seen the reaction of chemical recovery of the black liquor. And from that black liquor, sodium hydroxide, sodium sulfate and the sodium carbonate is removed. Then this, and also this black liquor is recycled back to the digester also. To maintain the temperature, you can see this arrow is moving towards this digester. Means this black liquor, we are also sending it back to the digester from here and from here also to maintain the temperature inside this digester. Hot water is added to this second filter for the better filtration. And after the filtration, this pulp is removed and the bleaching of the pulp takes place. The bleaching process is necessary to produce the white paper. The chemical used to bleach the pulp must be environment friendly. The bleaching with the chlorine produces the dioxide and other undesirable products. So use of chlorine sometimes avoided for the bleaching. So nowadays, the pulp is bleached with the hydrogen peroxide, ozone, chlorine dioxide, and the oxygen, etc. By using this chemical like hydrogen peroxide, ozone, chlorine dioxide, and oxygen, the raw material which we obtain from the chlorine is avoided So this is a better option. The objective of bleaching is to remove the small fractions of the lignin that remains after dyesation. And in this way, we get our final pulp, and this pulp is now ready to be used for the paper manufacturing. Thank you everyone for watching my video. I hope you people like my video. Please like and subscribe my channel for further notifications. Thank you everyone.